Thursday, August 27. Truth lovingly presented. Jesus did not neglect presenting truth for love's sake, because that would not have been love. Love always seeks the best for another. There is no conflict between love and truth. Truth presented humbly and kindly is a statement of love. Jesus said, "I am the way, the truth, and the life," John 14:6. Jesus is the only way of salvation, Acts 4:12. His grace saves us so that we can know His truth and live His life. Truth without love leads to stifling legalism, which strangles spiritual life. So-called love without truth leads to tolerant sentimentalism with no substance, leaving an individual adrift on a sea of uncertainty. Truth presented in love leads to an authentic Christian experience that provides clear direction, purpose, and certainty. Read 1 Peter 3:15, 2 Timothy 4:2, and Titus 3:4, 5. What expressions in these verses present the balance between presenting Bible truth and having a humble, accepting spirit? 1 Peter 3:15. But sanctify the Lord God in your hearts, and always be ready to give a defense to everyone who asks you a reason for the hope that is in you, with meekness and fear. 2 Timothy 4:2. Preach the word. Be ready in season and out of season. Convince, rebuke, exhort, with all long-suffering and teaching. Titus 3:4, 5. For but when the kindness and the love of God our Savior toward men appeared, 5. Not by works of righteousness which we have done, but according to His mercy He saved us, through the washing of regeneration and renewing of the Holy Spirit. The New Testament writers never emphasize love over truth. They beautifully blend love and truth, grace and law, compassion and honesty. Peter admonishes fellow believers to give a defense to everyone who asks you a reason for the hope that is in you, with meekness and fear, 1 Pet. 3:15, NKJV. In other words, you need to know what you believe, why you believe it, and be able to explain what you believe and why. This doesn't mean you must have all the answers or be able to convince others of your beliefs. It means only that with meekness and fear, that is, with humility and a sense of the greatness of the issues at stake, you can explain and defend your faith. Paul counsels his young protege Timothy, "Preach the word. Be ready in season and out of season. Convince, rebuke, exhort, with all long-suffering and teaching," 2 Tim. 4:2, NKJV. He reminds Titus that it is the kindness and love of God that save those who have been reborn in Him, Titus 3:5. We, too, are called to present the truth in love with all meekness and humility. Our Lord invites us to join Him in lovingly sharing with accepting attitudes His last day message for a world dying without Christ. If someone were to ask you, "Why are you a Christian?" how would you respond, and why? By Adult Sabbath School Guide.